Okay, to finish off our series on systems of linear differential equations, we're going to consider the case where the matrix is not diagonalizable. So here's our example. The matrix is 3, 1, negative 1, 1. We'll take initial conditions 5 and 2. And this is the same matrix that we use for non-diagonalizable difference equations. So the eigenvalue is 2, it has algebraic multiplicity 2, and geometric multiplicity 1. The only eigenvector is 1, negative 1, up to scale. But there's also a power vector, 0, 1. So if you apply a minus twice the identity to this, you get 0. You apply a minus twice the identity to this, you get the first eigenvector. Now the key observation is that our solution is still of the form e to the at times our initial condition. So let's put a box around that. And the point is, if you take the derivative of that, the derivative of e to the at by definition is ae to the at. And so you wind up with a times e to the at times x of 0. So that's a times x of t. So the derivative of this expression is a times itself. And if you plug in times 0, well, e to the at by definition at times 0 is the identity. Times x of 0 gives you x of 0. It works. And as always, we're going to let y be the coordinates of x in the b basis, where now b isn't a basis of eigenvectors, it's the basis of one eigenvector and one power vector. Okay, the only difference from the diagonalizable case is how we go from y of 0 to y of t. And we do this by just multiplying through by e to the at. You see, x of 0 is y1 of 0 b1 plus y2 of 0 b2. If we hit both sides of the equation by e to the at, well, we need to understand what e to the at does to the first eigenvector and what it does to the second power vector. b1 is an eigenvector, so we know what e to the at does to an eigenvector. It just multiplies by e to the eigenvalue times t. So that gives us e to the 2t b1. b2 is a power vector, so e to the at acting on b2 is a bit more complicated. You rewrite e to the at as e to the 2t times e to the a minus 2it, and you expand this out in a power series. So you get e to the 2t times b2 plus t a minus 2i b2 plus t squared over 2 a minus 2i squared b2 plus t cubed over 3 factorial a minus 2i cubed b2 plus so on forever. But it's a power vector. Power vector means, and it's power vector of degree 2, so a minus 2i squared acting on b2 is 0. This term is 0, the next term is 0, all the remaining terms are 0, and you're just left with, well, a minus 2i b2, we said that was b1, so you wind up with e to the 2t b2 plus t e to the 2t times b1. So if we plug that back into our expression for e to the at, well, if we want to know y1 and y2 of t at time t, together they make x of t, and that's e to the at x of 0, which we've just been working out. And we saw that it's y1 times e to the 2t b1, and then y2 of 0 times e to the 2t b2 plus t e to the 2t b1. And now the only way that this linear combination can be equal to this linear combination is if this is equal to the first expression and if this is equal to the second expression. So there we go. y1 of t is e to the 2t y1 of 0 plus t e to the 2t y2 of 0. And y2 of t is e to the 2t y2 of 0. Now we could write this in matrix form. And this matrix here is not the exponential, it's not e to the dt because it's not what you get when exponentiating a diagonal matrix, but it is what you get when exponentiating 2, 1, 0, 2. So what you get when you exponentiate the Jordan form of the matrix. Okay, so now we've got our equations for y of t in terms of y of 0, and we can go around our square. As always, we want to start off with x of 0, turn it into y of 0, y of t, and then x of t. So our change of basis matrix in one direction is negative 1, sorry, 1, 0, negative 1, 1, that's p. Our change of basis in matrix in the other direction is the inverse of this matrix. That's p inverse. And so we start off with 5, 2, and we multiply through by the change of basis matrix, and we get 5, 7. Then we use our formula for converting y of 0 into y of t, and we get some terms with e to the 2t in them, and we get some terms that go as t e to the 2t. Then we multiply through by the other change of basis matrix. And there we go. We've got our solution. It's got e to the 2t's in them, and it's got t e to the 2t's in them. And you see that if you plug in t equals 0, these terms die, and you get 5 e to the 0, 2 e to the 0. That's 5, 2. And that was our initial condition. Okay. So that's how you do it but with power vectors. You could also have done it with diagonalization and perturbations. We could have looked at a matrix that was just a perturbation of the original one. For example, if you added epsilon to the lower right-hand number, you would get a matrix that's diagonalizable. Since it's diagonalizable, you can compute its exponential by diagonalization. So you would convert x of 0 by taking p epsilon inverse to get y of 0. You multiply by the exponentials of the eigenvalues to get y of t. You multiply by the basis vectors to get x of t. And then you would have to take a limit as epsilon goes to 0. And some of the terms would involve 0 over 0. And you resolve this indeterminate form by using L'Hopital's rule, and that's where the t e to the t 2t would come from. So you can do it by perturbation, but in terms of getting the general form of the expressions, it's really more insightful to use power vectors, and that shows how when you have a non-diagonalizable matrix, you wind up with terms that look not just like e to the lambda t, but you wind up with lambda e to the lambda t expressions. If you had a power vector of degree 3, you would also have a lambda squared e to the lambda t. Degree 4, lambda cubed e to the lambda t. So solutions to differential systems of differential equations always involve exponentials, unless it's non-diagonalizable, in which case it involves powers of t times exponentials.